Let's start from talking about what fractals are. If you already know about them, you might want to skip to the next part where I'm talking about a simple way to draw fractals. Fractals are structures that exhibit self-similarity, or in other words, they replicate themselves at every scale. This might sound a little bit tricky, but in fact it's very simple. Let's take a look at a very simple fractal generated by the program I've recently written. It's called Sierpinski's triangle. Overall, it's triangle-shaped, but when you look deeper into it, the outermost structure repeats itself. There is a triangle in the center, and around it there are three smaller triangles. Then around each of the smaller triangles, there are yet another, three even smaller triangles, and it goes like that forever and ever. In fact, you can keep zooming and zooming, and there is no end to triangles popping out of the screen, in exactly the same arrangement. Even though the self-similarity rule might sound simplistic, the world of fractals is full of amazing structures like this. Want to learn how to draw something like this? In the next videos I'll explain how to generate them with code, but for now I'll try to explain how they are drawn using a simple game and where they come from in as simple way as possible. Let's continue with the main topic of this video. Now, a question arises. What's the big deal about fractals? Well, first of all, nature gives us lots of examples of fractals. Let's take a look at a tree. Like fractals, it exhibits self-similarity, and in fact the growing process of a tree is pretty much like drawing a fractal. It starts from the stem, then the stem splits and you get branches. Next, every branch splits and there are smaller branches, and finally twigs. It's pretty much like a fractal, however, this process obviously doesn't repeat itself forever. If you look at tree leaves, the veins in the leaves exhibit pretty much the same behavior. Another nice example is a fern, and there is even a mathematically described fractal, known as Barnsley's fern, that looks pretty much the same. Not only plants resemble fractals, think about lightning, it's got a very fractal shape. Now, when do fractals come from? All of this started from Benoît Mandelbrot, a French mathematician and computer scientist, who coined the term fractal, and rendered first fractals using computers. At first, pure mathematicians didn't like this guy. They couldn't see anything more in fractals than charlatanry and useless trick. Not to mention that he used complex numbers to describe his Mandelbrot set. But that's a different story. Soon it turned out how wrong they were. Mandelbrot continued his work, and soon others joined. Understanding fractals let mathematicians and scientists understand phenomena that were considered impossible to describe with mathematics, or simply too chaotic to draw useful conclusions. Fractal analysis was born, and it found applications in many domains of science like geology, astronomy, seismology, physics, and even music. It let us understand very complex and seemingly noisy signals and structures by analyzing their fractal dimension and other properties that turned out to be unique for certain patterns the signals and analyzed structures exhibit. And believe it or not, without it we wouldn't have things like pacemakers, and perhaps antennas in our mobile phones. This, however, is a different story, and I'll definitely make a video about it. Let's proceed to explaining how a fractal is made, and how to draw one. The first conclusion you might draw after I showed you how Sierpinski's triangle is made, is to use some transforms like translation, rotation, and scaling, to draw it using some recursive algorithm. You would start from a triangle, then draw three smaller ones at each side and repeat it over and over for each newly drawn triangle. That's one way to do it, but instead I'll show you a little bit more interesting and perhaps more entertaining way. It's called Chaos Game. Its rules can be modified, which I'll show you in a while. For the time being, let's show how to draw Sierpinski's triangle using this game. To proceed, you'll need a piece of paper, a die, and something to draw, plus most preferably a ruler. You start from three points that are the base of the fractal. You draw them and assign them die walls. Let's say the first point has walls 1 and 2. The second one has 3 and 4. And the last one 5 and 6. Now, you draw the first point somewhere in the middle. You roll a die, and there we go. Let's say you rolled 4, so you go for the second point. Now, the rule for this game, to draw Sierpinski's triangle, says that you have to travel half the distance from the last point to the point you have rolled. so you draw the next point here. You roll the die again. Let's say you rolled 2, so you go half the way from this point to that point, and you draw dots between them. You roll the die over and over and repeat the same pattern. It might seem chaotic at the first glance, but let's speed this process up a little bit using a computer program. Amazing! Out of chaos, order is born. We created our first fractal. Now, if you modify the rules and the points you choose by rolling the die, you might obtain many different and very interesting shapes. I found it quite entertaining, so I made a program that will do that for me in a simple way, letting me explore some more fractals on my own. In the next video, I'll show you how to draw fractals, and also I'll show you how to draw them in some more elaborate ways. So, if you cannot wait for the next video to come, please subscribe! And well, the new year is coming, so Happy New Year, and see you in the next video!